What up? The Drove is to here, the power of Kazakhstan. Today I bring you some Russian power, episode 14. Today's gun is Automat 91 or out or submachine gun 91. So this is a weapon designed by KBP Instrument Design Bureau, and it was created in 91. That's why it bears the name of 91. And its weight is 3.97 kilograms, length is 660 millimeters, width is 56 millimeters, the height is 291. The cartridge it uses is 7.62 by 39 millimeter, which is a standard Soviet or Russian round, and 5.56 by 45 millimeter, which is a NATO round, which is quite unusual for the Russian rifle because usually the Russian rifles use their own cartridges, but this bad boy uses also American rifles, which led me to believe that this weapon is also a spec-up weapon, aka Spetsnaz, or maybe you could say SWAT, something like that. Like, you know those special operation guys that work behind the lines, this weapon is for them. If they need to pick up the NATO rounds, they can just take the magazine of their dead enemies and plug it in. Or like stick it in the what's it called magazine of A91. Action uses is gas actuated rotating bolt. Rate of fire is 700 to 800 rounds per minute. Effective range is 1 kilometer with 7.62 by 39 millimeter rounds, but with NATO round it only goes up to 600 meters. Feed system is 30 round box magazine. As you can see, this rifle is a bullpup rifle, which actually makes it more useful in the special operations soldiers. Why? Because it is much shorter than your standard AK-47 or AK-74U red carbine, and also all the action happens in the rifle. There's no like extra parts such as buttstock on the rifle, which makes it really lethal for the special operations. And another thing that makes it more lethal, that you can use two types of cartridges, as I said before. And if you want to go with more grams on your gear, you pick the heavier cartridge, 7.62, or if you want a lighter, 5.56. Usually 5.56 is picked when there's more like close quarter combat, and this weapon is just perfect for close quarter because it doesn't go too far from your hand, from your farther hand that you hold in. A91 actually has a integrated the grenade launcher, and it is a part of the rifle. It is on the bottom front part. And it is pretty cool, good advantage that it's the part of the rifle. But one thing, one disadvantage, that if you use a silencer, you cannot use it because silencer will block your grenade launcher shots, and you might blow up yourself because either it's gonna bounce off and just do nothing, or it can blow you up. So you cannot use a grenade launcher with the sensor. Either you take it off or use a grenade launcher. Another disadvantage of this weapon, that the left-handed people or soldiers cannot use this weapon. Here's why: if you put it in left-handed and shoot, all the bullets, all the heated up bullets gonna go in your face, and it's gonna hurt, and also probably gonna burn your face. So this rifle is primarily made for the right-handed soldiers. Overall, this weapon is really good for the spec ops guys because it can shoot two caliber of bullets or two cartridges of bullets, two types. And also it is a bullpup version, which means it is much smaller than an AK, and it has an integrated grenade launcher, which is always good if you want to take out the wall or any group of enemies that are shooting on your position. And also make sure you don't confuse this rifle with 9A91. 9A91 was a carbine, and it wasn't a bullpup version, but this one is bullpup version, so this is a completely different rifle. Now let's talk about in-game characteristics of A91. It is an engineer kit, unlocked at 58,000 score as an engineer, which is a long way. I think it is a third engineer rifle that you unlock. Now, in the game, this rifle deals from 25 to 17 damage. Even with suppressor, the damage stays the same. So that means you can kill someone with 4 shots if they're really close. If you can deal the maximum damage, if you don't count the multipliers. What are multipliers? Is basically if you hit the head, you get extra damage. And 17 is at the longest range. And this rifle has 800 rate of fire. And the fire mode you can pick either fully automatic or semi-automatic. I always use fully automatic because you can spray with it. And it has a low recoil, which makes it a better long range weapon than other carbines such as SCAR-H, M4, or maybe G36CE. But almost all the carbines are pretty much balanced in recoil. But I always prefer this rifle because I'm just in love with this rifle, and I know this rifle doesn't look too good in my opinion, but still, it is pretty beastly. And actually, in Battlefield, A91 comes without the grenade launcher. They just took off. They just didn't model the grenade launcher. They just cut the barrel of the grenade launcher off. Kind of cool trick in my opinion. But right now, you're gonna see the class loadout that I love to use with A91, and it is pretty much the same setup as you can see in the video. A91, Corbo sight, any red dot sight will do, silencer and a foregrip. And I use silencer primarily to stay off the radar, because Battlefield 3, the silencers, if you don't use a silencer and you shoot unsilenced weapon, you show up in radar, and radar in Battlefield 3 is so lethal. Because they can spot you, and if somebody spots you, pretty much guarantee that they're gonna go after you. I use foregrip to decrease my horizontal recoil. Foregrip does not decrease the vertical recoil. It only decreases the horizontal recoil, which means the weapon's gonna go less left to right, and you're gonna stay on target much better. And the Cobra sight I use primarily for a better visibility, because A91 has pretty bad iron sights, at least for me. I don't really like them, and I will use any optical attachment with this gun, and I would recommend it too. And I would recommend using red dot sight and holographic. And if you want, use ACOG, but never use a battle scope or the sniper scopes in any of the engineer rifles, or preferably also the medic rifles. Also, if you're running engineer or assault with any rifle, anything, even M16 or AK-74M, always use the ammo perk, because you're gonna get the double ammo than you would normally, and it is really helpful if you're gonna stay out for the long streaks and don't want to pick up somebody's support class and dropping ammo, or picking up somebody's rifle which has unsuppressed, or has tactical light, something that you don't like. And it is also helpful if you don't have the really good support player that doesn't give too much ammo, and that's what usually happens to me. There's not too many good support players give ammo. And please, if you're playing support, just give ammo to your teammates. Battlefield 3 overall in 91 is beastly. It's one of the best engineer rifles out there. If you haven't used it, I recommend use it now if you have unlocked it. And this episode comes to an end. Russian Power episode 14 is done. Use this rifle, absolutely beast as I said before, and use ammo on it, because it's gonna run out really fast. Thanks for watching. Draft 2.